لقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Welcome back to Tajweed Easy. This is your brother Abu Muhammad. In the last few lessons, we finished one of the most important topics in Tajweed, which is Al-Waqf. We found out what this is, its importance, when to stop and when not to stop. Today, inshallah, we're going to do the second part, which is Al-Ibtida. We'll find out what Al-Ibtida is, its different categories, and how to apply this rule properly. So we have here Al-Ibtida. Al-Ibtida means the start, to start a recitation. Now, to start a recitation is of two types. Number one, to start completely from scratch. So I'm opening a mushaf, this particular ayah, I want to start from this particular ayah. This is considered as Al-Ibtida. This is the first part. The second part is reciting an ayah. So I'm reciting ayah, I finish an ayah, I take a short pause to renew my breath, and then I'll start the next ayah. This is also considered as Al-Ibtida as well. So the first part is opening mushaf or starting a recitation from a particular ayah without having read anything beforehand. And the second part, second category, is reciting and taking a short pause, whether this is at the end of an ayah or at the end of the surah. So I'm finishing a surah, I finish, I take a short pause so I can renew my breath and start the following ayah or the following surah. This is considered starting. So starting, or the start, al-ibtida, is of two categories. Number one, al-ikhtiyari. Number two, al-ikhtibari. Now we're just going to quickly just summarize this topic, and then after that we'll do the first part in more detail in this lesson. Al-ikhtiyari means the optional start. Okay, so al-ibtida al-ikhtiyari. So to start because you have your own choice. So I'm reciting an ayah, I want to stop at this particular place, and I want to start at this particular place. So I'm starting at a particular place due to my own choice. This is of two categories, subcategories. Number one, jaiz. Number two, ghayr jaiz. Jaiz just means what's allowed. There's three groups, okay? In this subcategories, there's three groups. Number one, tam. Number two, kaf. Number three, hasan. We'll find out more in detail what we mean. And ghayr jaiz, what's not allowed in the optional start. So you start, I'm starting with my own choice, what's not allowed, is something called, this is a ghayr jaiz, what's not allowed is a ibtida, which is qabih, which is repulsive start. We'll find out why it's called repulsive and what's the ruling on this. So jaiz, what's allowed is three groups, what's not allowed is one group. This is what al-waqf al-ikhtiyari, this is what we're going to be looking at today, inshallah. The next part is waqf al-ikhtibari. This next category is al-ibtida al-ikhtibari, okay? Starting due to being examined by a teacher. So the teacher will give you an ayah, and will tell you to start at a particular place in an ayah. What you need to do as a student is to think about that particular word. What's the first letter of that word? Or what's the last letter of the word? Because in the Arabic language, sometimes a word can be written or pronounced certain way when you're continuing, but when you're starting in that particular word, it can change due to grammar rules. For example, part of the ayah here, this is Surah Al-Hajj, ثُمَّ الْيَقْطَعْ فَلْيَنْظُرْ. Your teacher tells you to start from this particular ayah. Then you think to yourself, لِيَقْطَعْ, can I say لِيَقْطَعْ, can I start a word with a sukoon? In the Arabic language, you can never start a word with a sukoon. The Arabs never used to do that. So you have to think about it. How do I start this? So this particular lamb, there's a verb here, okay? And there's this particular lamb. What does this lamb do when we're starting a recitation? So in this particular ayah, we'll put a kasra, لِيَقْطَعْ. So if I'm going to start here, ثُمَّ لِيَقْطَعْ, start from here, so I will say liyaqta with a kasra. Why is this the case? Because of the grammatic rule in this word. This is what we're going to be looking at, ikhtibari. So some of the different examples in the Quran, where when you're stopping at a particular place, it changes when you're starting at that particular word. And you notice something, there's no middle category. There's no ibtida'il ihtirari. There's no forced starting. You can never be forced to start a recitation. It can either be from your own choice, or it can be an exam from a teacher. You can never be forced. Whereas the waqf, stopping, there is waqf al-iltirar, stopping due to being forced to stop. Why? Because you're running out of breath, or you forgot the next ayah, or you don't know where you are, you're forced to stop at a particular place. So inshallah, now we're going to look at the first category, al-ikhtiyari, in more detail. Now we have you on the board, al-ibtida al-ikhtiyari. the optional start. And we said from the optional start, or the starting with options, there's three types that are allowed and one type that's not allowed. Now, inshallah, we're going to go over in detail using the ayats to understand what we mean. Before we start, an important note to make here is that starting is of two types. Number one, starting from scratch, meaning I'm opening a mushaf and I'm actually starting from that particular word. This is considered as the first type. And the second type is I read an ayah, I finish an ayah, and I renew my breath. So I read an ayah, I take a pause, renew my breath, and continue from next ayah. This is also considered as starting. So we're going to compare these two parts with the different groups. Number one, the first group is ibtida'u tam, al-ibtida'u tam. Al-ibtida'u tam just means a complete starting. What does this mean? This means starting on an ayah, starting on a Quranic word that has no meaning or grammar attached to what's previous to that. For example here, this ayah, Allah talks about the example of the disbelievers and the believers. Allah says that the example is like the blind, those who can see, and so on. Then Allah continues until the end of the ayah. Allah says, أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Do they not ponder? Do they not think? Then Allah starts with a new topic. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا. Indeed, we sent Nuh to his people, and so on. So here, this is a new topic. Can we start from here? So the two types of starts. Number one, can I open a mushaf and start from وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا? Yes, I can do that. Why? Because this is a new topic. Can I continue from what was previous to that? So I can continue, I can take a pause, and I can start. So both types of starts are allowed in ibtida'u tam, the complete start. Both types of starts are allowed. So I can open a mushaf and I can start from here, or I can go to what's previous to that, take a pause, and I can continue. All the beginning of the surahs are considered as ibtida'u tam, complete start. Why? Because a new topic, new subject, and all the different stories of the prophets and so on, they're considered as ibtida'u tam. So next group is ibtida'u kaf, the sufficient start. What does this mean? This means we're starting on a Quranic word, and previous to that, from that word to what's previously, there's a link in terms of meaning. So this word and what's previous to that is a link in meaning. So what does this mean? For example, in the same story of Nuh, Allah says, "Inni akhafu alaykum 'adhaba yawmin 'azim." Okay, I fear for you a punishment on a very painful day. فَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. So Allah says after this, so this is a new ayah. So those eminent, those high people in the society amongst the disbelievers, they said this and this and this. Can I start from فَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا? Can I start from this ayah? So the first type of stop, open your mushaf and start from this ayah, I cannot do that. Why is that the case? Because if I do that, okay, people around me, okay, whether in salah or people who are around me, who are going to listen to me, they're going to question which people who said this. So if I said the people who are eminent amongst the disbelievers said this, which people who are eminent is going to make people confused. Okay, so we cannot start from the beginning. But we can do the other start, which is continue from this ayah, take a pause and then carry on from that, that's fine. But from here, we should not do that. Why? Because we should give it a complete story. So start from وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا, the story of Nuh, then carry on. But from here, we cannot do that. Number three is ابتداء حسن, the good stop. What does this mean? This means starting on a Quranic word, and what's previous to that, there's a link in grammar and meaning. So starting on a word, and what's previous to that, there's a link in grammar and meaning, which is very similar to kaf. Kaf is just meaning here, the grammar and meaning. What's the ruling on that? There's two types. Number one, the beginning of an ayah. Number two, in the middle of the ayah. If it's the beginning of the ayah, so I'm starting. So for example, Allah says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. Wail is for those who pray. Wail is destruction, okay? Or specific mountain, hellfire for those who pray. Which people who pray? الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ. So الَّذِينَ is a description. It's an adjective for those who pray. Who pray. So now we're describing those who pray. الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَهُونَ. Those who are heedless in the salah. These types of people, okay, this الَّذِينَ goes back to those who pray. Those people who are heedless in the salah. They either pray late, they don't pray properly, and so on. So what's the ruling on this? The ruling on this is that because there's a relationship in grammar and meaning, what we have to do is, if we're going to start from scratch, from opening a mushaf, I cannot start from الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Because why? Because it's going to question which people are these kind of people. So we should start from فَوَيْلُ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. So the first type of start, you cannot do that. But the second type of start, continue from an ayah, taking a pause and continue, this is fine. The second type of start, these types of ayats, because there's a relation, grammar and meaning, you can either stop, continue, or you can join it. So you can say فَوَيْلُ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ or فَوَيْلُ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. So both are correct. This is if it's in the beginning of an ayah. If it's in the middle of an ayah, what's the rule in that? For example, Allah says الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ, those who give in charity from the wealth, سِرَّ وَعَلَانِيَ, okay, بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ, okay, night and day in secret and open, فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ, for them is a reward عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, for them is a reward with their master. If someone were to continue reciting and stopping فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ, for them there's a reward, the meaning is good, it gives a good meaning. But can we start from what's after that? With the Lord, we cannot do that. We have to go back. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, they'll receive reward from their Rabb, from their Master. So we cannot start from if it's in the middle of an ayah, we cannot stop and continue straight after. You have to go back and complete the meaning. So this is ibtida hasan. And the last one, so these three types are allowed. The last one, al-qabih, the repulsive or the ugly start. What does this mean? This means starting on a Quranic ayah, so Quranic word, starting on a Quranic word that gives a bad meaning because what's previous to that, there's an attachment in meaning in grammar, there's an attachment in meaning to what's previous to that. For example, Allah says, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةً. The Jews, they say that Allah's hands are tight, meaning Allah's stingy. If someone would say, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودِ, the Jews said, then stop, then say, يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةً, Allah's hands are tight, we cannot do that. We have to join everything properly, so it gives a complete and good meaning. Okay, so we cannot say وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودِ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةً. Similar ayats, Allah says وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَحِبَّهُ. The Jews and the Christians, they say that we are Allah's children, the most beloved. We cannot say وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى, then stop, نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَحِبَّهُ, we're the children of Allah and so on. We cannot do that. Why? Because it will give a very bad meaning, repulsive meaning against what Allah intends. So here we have the three types of stops, three types of starts that are allowed, which is a tam, kaf and hasan, and al-qabih, which is not allowed. So today we covered al-ibtida' al-ikhtiyari, the optional starting, the three types are allowed, and one type that's not allowed. In the next lesson we'll start al-ibtida' al-ikhtibari, the examining start, when the teacher tells the student to stop at a particular word. And these words, they change based upon grammar. We'll find out some of these words so we can understand how to apply this rule. Until then, jazakumullah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.